Mr. Charles Armstrong and the staff and management of Heaven invite you to join us in welcoming to the stage our guest of honor, Miss Naomi Sims.
I have to say, first of all, thank you so very much for being so kind and so nice and so wonderful for being here tonight. I want to especially, I'm going to do this real quick because you guys know how I am. If you've like ever been around, you know I never know when to shut up. Tonight, I will shut up, I swear, because the last couple of months has been a roller coaster. I lost my best friend on March 12th, 1 week exactly before my birthday. I honestly believe that I was never going to be one of the numbers. For those of you who don't know, okay, now you do. I never wanted to know because I thought as long as I believed that I would stick by, I would go on, that was what gave me my strength and my determination. And I lost somebody who meant a lot to me, and I quit on March 12th, I quit. A week before my birthday. So for all those of you who have talked about me and said things about me and have like questioned and wondered, yes, I have a problem. And it's not just one. I've got several. Problem is that all I ever wanted to do was to do a good job to make somebody else happy. That's why I did drag, because it was the only thing I knew that I could do that I thought was of any value. I came from a functional family, and I failed. But the only legacy that I have is that I have the best friends on earth. I have Mr. Charles Armstrong, who was there for me, even though we had our differences on too many occasions. But Charles said, you have the ball, you run with it. If you fuck up, I hold you responsible. I used to think the same way, but then I started to think there's that consideration in human error. Everybody from time to time makes a mistake. Well, Saul taught me something very valuable. Alan Gellman, who's been there for me through thick and through thin and never questioned. Yeah, but he spread some shit about me, but it wouldn't be Alan. I am humbled because this show of affection and attention is at the same time, I'm so full of pride. So, like, how can I have one of the deadly virtues and one of the greatest things on earth? To be humble and proud at the same time. I am humbled because I cannot believe and fathom for the life of me that so many people sincerely care about me. It hurts. No, please. I do not wish to be dramatic, therefore I wrote these things down. You don't understand, but I have had some wonderful experiences and some great moments. But tonight is the greatest moment of my life, because you are here because you want to be and you sincerely care. I love you just as much as you love me, and I hope that I didn't ever forget to say thank you, and if I did, I do now. I also have to tell you that I wanted so very much to see me and to be happy and to perform, and I never thought that I was any different from anyone else. Just dedicated and committed to this art form because I wasn't too amazing. Just let me finish and I'll leave you alone. I swear to God, I'll never, ever bore the shit out of you again. I swear tonight on... And I swore I wasn't gonna curse, Mary. You made me curse. Okay, I'm gonna read this about that. I was surrounded by the best, is why I feel so good. If there was anything that I knew what was good. I knew what was talented. I was taught that. because my parents ready me to be better than because I was a second class citizen, a Negro, and I had to make a money. And I had, because for all those of you who know me, you never ever thought of me. Not that I'm not proud of those things, I'm terribly proud of those things. The problem is that I feel that because brothers and sisters are a person. You guys did that to me. I never suffered any kind of racism or bigotry because you got to know me and accepted me. I appreciate that. That is the most important thing. But most of you only know me from the first time I've ever heard before. But I wanted to be a person and now Tiffany Jones because she was my inspiration. We differed on occasion, but we both had the same idea. I wanted to be as popular and loved and popular as well as my friend. I wanted to be as dynamic as Donna Day. I wanted to be creative and as ingenious as Tasha Cole. I wanted to be all those things, but time and time again, the person said that I fell into the room, that I was the most imperfect, and all I was me. And what I had to do was to show it. And that was the greatest moment that ever happened to me. I had the best company around me, and that's why I look good. I fooled you all. I did. For the greater part of that time, I was blessed with the best emotions with very good friends. Friends that on times when I called them and I said, "Hi, how are you?" I'll fight to the end. I think I want to take it down. I'm so sure. But the problem is that tonight gave me the strength and the desire to fight, to go on and to be better. I thank tonight. I ask you, please, let me be a little patient with you. That's all I ask. And I ask that you guys understand. Everybody's special. It's your friend. Somebody who has the most incredible life, you have no idea how to let out of here. I have been given the world and the planet, and I have fucked it up. And now I'm going to make it right. I'm going to take you all. The last thing on earth that I ever want to do is any of you play like I played when I lost the game. So I tell you what. I got it. Is that I'm stubborn and strong-willed and strong-headed, and you know that, don't you? Yes. So, I'm ready for the joy and the happiness to be the best. I'm not going nowhere. I refuse. I am here, and Alan, Charles, Donna, Tasha, and each and every one of you, I have a reason now, because I don't want to see any one of you hurt because of me. All I want to do is make you happy. Well, I'm going to keep on making you happy. Okay? I have a reason. Michael, I have a reason, Alan, because I owe you all so much.